explorers, and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about what I am building at the moment. I have actually not done any research for any new topics this week and so on, because I'm really invested in building a specific app that I've been thinking about for a while. I knew that there was no open source solution for this for Android, so I was really keen on building this application. So I'm going to talk about the technology, and we start by thinking that we have a device, a secure device. So in the middle here I will paint a little rectangle here. So this is our secure device, and somewhere we have a server over here, or a cloud, that we want to authenticate to. So we want to tell the cloud that we are someone, and we really don't want the cloud to know that we are a specific person. That's not really that important. The only thing that is important is that the same person is talking to the cloud as last time we talked to the cloud, and we can do that in a secure way. And this specific technology is called SQRL, and that stands for Secure Quick Reliable Login. And the two letters in the middle here, QR, that stands could also stand for QR code, because in this technology you actually use QR codes a lot. So this cloud over here could either present us with a link or some QR code that we could scan with our secure device. So that's the first step. So our phone scans this code and we get some nonce over here. So that's a secure number, it's one time, it's something that the server came up with, and it's unique, and nobody has ever seen it, and anyone can read this code. It's not that secretive, it's just a start of a value. Then we use our key that we have stored over here in our secure device. And there's a lot of implementation to make this key secure. We take this key and we create a response to the server for this nonce. So we send something back to the server. And this response, it's unique for our key. It's unique for the server. And it's also unique for this transmission, because we have this nonce that starts the whole process. So the server will know that one key, the public part of this key over here, has been seen before for this server. And when you get this response back for the scanning of this QR code, the server can actually log us in. So if we actually are going to a web page, the thing could actually be that we present the web page, we scan the code, and the web page then redirects us directly to a new page where we're in logged in. So that's a really interesting point of this protocol, that you can actually just go somewhere, scan this page, and you are in. So it's a very fast process. Of course, this secure device over here needs to be secured in some way. You can have fingerprint scanning, you can have your password, you can have some smaller, simpler passkey, and you can do a lot of things on this device to keep yourself secure in this loop. But the simplicity of having this unlocked and just going to a website, scanning your code, and you're logged in, it's a very nice way to actually authenticate you to a server. And with this technology, you don't need a username and password field. You don't need any third-party authentication or something, because it's good enough to know that you have this secure device. So that's one thing that you have, and you also have your secure login on the device. So if this client over here is built correctly, you also have supplied the correct login credentials for this device. The server doesn't know that. For the server, it's just that the device came again. So you could actually add login and password as an extra measure on this side and so on, but it's not required. So this technology over here is something that I'm looking into, and this specific key here could also be saved to either paper or to some hard drive. See if you can draw something different. Could look something like that. So you can either save it to a file on hard disk or to a piece of paper that you can save somewhere. And so if we go over here and look at this piece of paper, so a key could look something like this. This is my test key that I'm using at the moment and trying to get this to work. And this test key is such that there is a lot of security in this test key. So you create your very secure password in order to decrypt this key and also verify that this key is correct. And there is technology to restore your key if you forgot the password. And there's also, if you didn't remember the password, it's gone. You don't have any information there. But if you actually you want to change your identity to a specific server, let's say that you use an identity on a server and you don't want to use that identity again, you want to change identity, there's a lot of key management that goes into actually updating your identity so you can have a new identity. You can also have multiple identities and so on in this device. So what I'm trying to implement now, as there could be some kind of generator over here, and that means that I need to, on the device, figure out something that is secure and that is random and so on in order to generate keys. So this could be a task that I want to do in order to actually have keys. And I also need to figure out a way to store keys on the device in a secure manner in order to have the keys there, not by this crazy way that you store on disk on paper, but in a more easily usable way. Because when you store on paper, there is actually a functionality in this protocol that when you save to a paper or to a disk, you have a time function there. So if you have a good computer and say that I want to print out this key, it will take a specific amount of time to create this key. And if you open that key on a different device, that will take a specific amount of time, depending on how good the device is, to actually unlock this key. So for instance, my computer over here is pretty good. So it took me 5 seconds to create this key, but on my Android device, it took multiple minutes to open this key up. So you might be wondering, why is it important that it takes time to create this key and to actually save it? That's because if you set a time limit and say this specific function that works in memory, so you need a lot of memory, not a lot of memory for an Android device or for a modern computer, but if you have integrated circuits, it's a lot of memory. So you need memory and you also need time in order to do this, because if you say that you do it for 5 seconds, you get an iteration of number of times you do this calculation. It means that every time that I want to try a password, if I have a really good device like my computer or even greater, it will take 5 seconds for every try. And that's a lot if you want to do millions of tries or billions of tries. So this key is quite crazy, so I need to figure out a way to save it, store it on the device in a secure manner that isn't this crazy. So to make this little protocol here, my first thought was I want to understand how these are actually saved, and I want to read these correctly, because I thought that that might be the easiest thing. So my thought was, create some Android app over here that can read this key and show a good progress that they are reading the key, and now we're opening up your key, and then use the key on a server. And this kind of process that we have here is not something that you want to use every time, but it's a good way to see that you have something that works. Because if I can take this kind of a key that is created by the designer of this protocol, so everything that you want to know about SQRL or SQRL as it's pronounced, you can go to grc.com/SQRL and read about it there. So the maintainer of this protocol has made a program that can create these keys. So I have created a bunch of these keys, written them out. I want to understand how to read them in and use them on the network. And this part of using them on the network that I have implemented before in Go and so on, so I'm quite sure about how to do that. So now I'm in the process of reading these keys, and I find it really fascinating, and I'd like to actually have some code that I can write in my spare time. This is open source, it's on my GitHub page under secure, quick, reliable login, so you can go there. I will put the link in the description of this video, and I hope that you found this little explanation of what I'm working on now interesting. I hope that you like it, share it with your friends or colleagues, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. If you want to contribute, just give me a pull request on GitHub. If you want me to talk more about this or have any suggestions, leave me a comment, and I really hope to see you in the next video.